According to a recent insider scoop, Valve is preparing the most revolutionary anti-cheat in history. But is that really so? When it be released? And will it be able to handle the influx of cheaters that has taken over CS2? These are the questions I'll try to answer today. Hello Predators, it's MultiAlexson. Let's see if we can expect a safe cheater-free future. It's been 9 months since the first CS2 announcement, but in all this time, the developers still haven't officially presented the new anti-cheat VAC live. According to Richard Lewis, Valve wanted to announce the release of its revolutionary anti-cheat in one of its trailers for a new game, but backtracked, as didn't finish working on it in time. In addition, Lewis confirmed that a new anti-cheat will surpass its competition. These words gave hope to every player who can no longer tolerate pompous cheaters appearing in almost every match of a new game and announcing their illegal actions with no fear whatsoever. Sure, there were cheaters in the previous version too, but not nearly as many as now. Now the floodgates have opened and they can't be closed. Reason? Of course, bad anti-cheat is always the main problem, but the number of cheaters in CS2 is also growing due to desire to get new multi-digit numbers. In other words, the new rating system and leaderboard have contributed to the increase in dishonest, cunning and crafty players. It's for a place on the leaderboard cunning players buy cheats to help them reach glory and become the best players in the world. But the icing on the cake isn't even the cheats themselves. It's the fact that these people announce their actions publicly and face zero repercussions. For example, a cheater nicknamed Satan, who is currently in the 58th place on the leaderboard, admitted that he plays using prohibited cheats. He is not hiding and instead openly gave a big interview about his activities, spoke about the cheats he uses and shared that every other player at the top uses prohibited programs, and that their win rate is 90%. It's been a month. Do you think he was blocked or removed from the leaderboard? No! How is one supposed to play Premier after this? Anti-cheat doesn't block him. Everyone knows who he is and what cheat he uses. Nothing happened. It's completely bullshit. The entire community, influencers and pro players all talk about cheaters in Premier, and Valve is choosing to stay quiet. However, disappointing statistics suggest that everything is about to change and Valve will have to finish its revolutionary anti-cheat as soon as possible. In November alone, the number of unique players decreased by 6.4 million. Reasons may vary, but most agree that cheaters are the reason, as well as the inability by the new anti-cheat to block them. One hope remains: anti-cheat update and a revolutionary approach. As we now see, the developers are working on it. A new VAC Live anti-cheat proves it. This is the same old neural network, previously called VACnet, which has been learning how to filter various parameters and watch bizarre robot-like habits players may have since 2016. The only thing that sets VAC Live apart from VACnet is that it can block a cheater directly in a match without having to wait for the next ban wave. In general, its job is to find a cheater right during the match and consequently, in case of successful hunt, to finish the match. In theory, it's all easy. A lot of headshots through the walls, twitches or robot-like shooting, you get banned. End of story. Unfortunately, it doesn't work in practice yet. Most old cheaters continue to cheat. Rumor has it, it's because Valve hasn't launched all of its revolutionary methods that are supposed to uncover and punish cheaters. No one knows when it will press the red button. Valve never discloses information to not let cheaters prepare for what's to come and avoid their fate. It was even speculated that the anti-cheat would be released December 5th. Something indeed happened on the day. There was a new ban wave, but as it turned out, not for cheaters, but for regular players.
Oh no, 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 no! No!
Consequently, 17,000 accounts were affected. Valve, of course, doesn't comment on what caused this massive unjust ban, but they say the recent Nvidia driver update may have been at fault. Let me remind you that prior to that, at the beginning of October, there was another ban wave among AMD graphic card owners for updating a driver that contained anti-lock plus technology. Do you think it was a coincidence, or has Intel decided to mug their competitors a bit? Anyway, it's clear as day after all the unfair banning that a new revolutionary anti-cheat is not yet ready to be presented and has its side effects. However, such mistakes are inevitable. The main thing is that the developers continue working in new ways to fight cheaters no matter what. I think the new anti-cheat will be ready by next season, somewhere in January or February. Not long to wait. There is another question that worries me. Can the new anti-cheat do its job of eradicating past and future cheaters? After the release and enabling the neural network, bans for many old cheaters are to be expected. They'll cry and beg to get their accounts back to not lose their precious inventory. But some time will pass and creators of cheats will adapt and find flaws in the revolutionary anti-cheat. New accounts will then be a click away and the good old cheaters will be back in the game. Even using AI, they will not be able to get rid of cheaters completely, as those creating forbidden programs also use AI to create more complex cheats. This is an endless battle and there's no end to it. The only thing Valve can do is to reduce the number of cheaters. One possible way of doing that might be using fingerprints or other biometric data for players' authentication. This approach will definitely make it more difficult to create or use fake accounts. But even this almost perfect approach is not perfect upon further inspection. Cheaters can find ways to bypass something as intricate as biometric authentication. In addition, this idea requires a large team and sums of money, which I don't think Valve will do. All they can do is continue to constantly improve and teach their neural network new detection methods, constantly update and have new waves of bans. In other words, to fight an endless battle in which neither side will ever win. What do you think about the problems with cheaters in CS2? Is it possible to reduce and limit their numbers, or is it hopeless and the new game will soon die under the weight of these honest players? Leave a comment below, while I'll be preparing the next video, which will be released shortly. So if you don't wanna miss this or any other CS2-related or club-related videos, leave your warm likes, subscribe to our channel Ikla, and support our players! As always, it was MultiAlexson, see you in the next video, Predators!